Guess the Borough Fan TV. Motard the Riverside, we've beaten Hull 3-1. I'm happy. Ryan, 3 goals at home. It's been a while.
Yeah, good win. It's what I expected, really. I come into this game expecting a win. I was a bit worried before that we wouldn't. It's the type of game where you just expect a 1-1 or slip up, but we haven't. Gusted's got on the score sheet. But I bet you Bernie Slavin's eating his words. You saw him putting in the Gazette saying, what's Gusted doing starting? Why is he in the club? Sam Bong should be up front. Bernie Slavin, you're past it. Just stick to, you know, your old game, pal. Rudy Gusted is going to lead this club forward. Under Pulis, Gusted is the man. As simple as that. Asambonga does not fit the system under Pulis. Yeah, Gusted might have his off days. Every striker does. But we're not going to go anywhere with Asambonga up front. As Gusted proved today, he worked hard. He fight for every ball. I've never seen Gusted so up for it. You know, he must have got, you know, something off Pulis. Because after Cardiff, he was disappointing. He lost his headers. Didn't have the best of games, but today, quality striker's performance, that from Rudy Gusted.
Like you say, plenty of the fans on Saturday were saying, if Gusted's our striker for the rest of the season, going forward, they didn't see much hope for the future of this season, but I think he's proved a few wrong tonight.
Well, again, Borough fans on Twitter, you know, in Gusted's mentions after he tweeted saying, you're shit. Final laughs on you, isn't it? You know, why would you say that? Why would you tweet a player directly saying you're shit? Why? And he's just proved them all wrong today, you know, and I'm happy for him. I really am.
Patrick Bamford has proved a few wrong tonight as well, Ryan.
Including me. Yeah, I've been a massive critic over Bamford the last few weeks, but I'm not going to change my mind. I'm not going to defend his performances over the last few weeks. They have been poor. But today, he did improve. I thought overall in the game, he wasn't great, but he got his goal. That's what matters. He made an impact in the game. That's what he's been lacking for the last few weeks. So fair play to him, and hopefully can kick on now, score a few more goals and helping our later promotion push.
No Johnny Howson in the starting lineup, Ryan. Were you surprised?
I was, but I thought Besic and Ledbetter played well. I think Besic did carry Ledbetter a little bit, he outperformed him. I thought Besic was my man the match today, personally. He controlled the game. You can see his Premier League class. You know, he's composed on the ball. You know, he takes his time when he needs to, but then when he can go forward, he does. He looks for that forward pass. And that's what we've been missing, someone in the midfield who can look forward and play that pass, but actually make the pass instead of seeing it and not making it. Like that over-the-top ball when he received the ball from Ayala to Bamford. Bamford's touch did let him down. That just how you can go from back to front that quickly. That's what you want to see from a midfielder.
And Dale Fry slotting in for an ill Ben Gibson. Looked like he'd been there all season.
Accomplished. He's done that every time one of our defenders have had to drop out. I think he was very unlucky against Norwich at the start of the season. Obviously made a mistake, never really got a look in after that, but he's coming today and, you know, he's cleared one off the line, which was a crucial point in the game. You know, if that goes in, pressure's back on us. It's a bit like Reading all over again. And he's cleared that off the line. He won his headers. Him and Ayala good together, like they have been playing together all season. So it's good to see that if a defender does get injured or sick or whatever, what Ben Gibson was, we've got Dale Fry who can come in and do a good job.
With us being in the position that we're in, I've got to ask, are we going to make the playoffs, Ryan?
Last week I said no. Well, against Reading I said no. I'm still going to say no. It's a tough ask. We've just been too inconsistent for me to say yes. Obviously I'm hopeful we can. I hope we can. I'm going to be optimistic. I'm going to go to the game supporting the team wanting to win so we can get in the playoffs. But my heart's telling me we're not going to. Unfortunately, we're just going to fall short. But we'll let Pulis, if we don't, we'll let Pulis bring his own players, you know, his own squad. Fans are slating Pulis in. They want him out already. We're not Leeds. We don't want to be Leeds fans. That's what Leeds fans do. Leeds, you know, the call for the managers to be sacked after 5 games. We don't want to be like that. Let's build something like we did under Crank. It never worked first time. Let him build his own squad, get his own players in, and we'll be right back up there.
Ryan, thanks for coming on Borough Fan TV.